Sorry I didn't hear you there. I was just playing with my nuts. I know why you're here. Yes, I know why you're here. You are here to know what it's like to date a nerd, right? Yeah, you are. Well, we'll start with this.
They're useful in this tech-savvy world. It's great to have a BF who can make your laptop, desktop, and just about anything else that plugs into your wall behave itself.
What are you doing?
I'm in your computers, upgrading your RAMs.
Due to their neglected status, there are plenty to choose from. You like them tall and slender? There are plenty of geeks, nerds, who are. You like them smaller and more meat on their bones? Got that too. They've got brains. Come on now. How can intelligence be a bad thing? Most nerds are really good at remembering dates, like birthdays and such, especially if it's near a release date, something they've been waiting for a very long time. They're relatively low maintenance. Most can be fueled on pizza, Twinkies, and Mountain Dew. No complicated dinners needed here. So if you're not the best cook, hey, can you order a pizza? You also don't have to worry about them flirting with other girls, because usually 9 out of 10 times, they'll zip right by them and make a beeline towards the nearest electronics store. I've seen this happen before.
Why are you late?
I'm all out of love. I'm so lost without you. I know you were right, believing for so long. I'm all out of love. What am I without you? I can't be too late to say that I was so wrong.
Although he may not want to go with you on every outing with you, you can arrange swaps, as in, you'll go to his GamerCon dressed like an elf princess if he'll take you to the ballet. Plus, if he doesn't want to go someplace with you, you don't have to worry about what he's up to. You'll probably come home and find him asleep on his keyboard and see if Mountain Dew cans with code blinking up on the screen. It's okay, he's used to this. Just toss a blanket over him and turn out the lights. They're rarely, if ever, possessive. They trust you, so you can be yourself around them. You like to walk around the house in a ratty t-shirt for comfort? He won't care. He does it too. They won't get pissy if you don't wear makeup or don't want to bother primping up your hair. If you gain a few pounds, they won't try their best to make you feel like crap. They're usually very well educated, physics majors and stuff like that. And you don't have to listen to him blathering on about his car, okay, maybe a little. He'll have loads of other interesting things to talk about, politics, world events, but much more about what's going on with his computer.
Somewhere, and like I couldn't do anything about it, so he just told me to install Linux, so I did, and I love it ever since. It's awesome.
You'll almost never hear have to hear, "Yeah, dog, what's up?" plop out of their mouths, unless it's in a gist. They spell properly, use correct punctuation, and are able to tell the difference between the toilet and the floor. They almost never get wasted, so you don't have to worry about coming home to find him and his friends passed on the floor amidst a pile of beer bottles. Mountain Dew cans, perhaps.
Thank you.
Victoria's Secret models. So gross, you can see their ribs. How is that feminine?
Ooh.
And the final reason why geeks and nerds make the best boyfriends, they actually give a hoot about you. Not how you look, though that's a plus. Not how skinny you are, and how much makeup you print yourself up with, but they like you for who you are. That kind of thing lasts longer than, baby, you gotta find booty. Leave me.